Hello everyone, this is Anjali Wahingbom and you're watching Imoinu Live Top 20 News. An inaugural program of Lamyanba Hija Mirabot statue at Palarbon Kasar was held today, which was organized by Hija Mirabot Ningsinglo Palarbon. Lakhipur MLA Kaushik Rai, MDC Chairperson Reena Singha and President of Patriotic Writers Forum Manipur Naurem Khamba Luang were the dignitaries at the function. Chief Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma said that the Assam government has been encouraging maximum use of green fuel to reduce environmental damage. The Chief Minister also said that the agreement signed between Punjab National Bank and Assam Biorefinery is a good beginning, which will encourage the farmers to cultivate bamboo and help in producing green energy. Union Minister for Development of Northeastern Region Shri G. Kishan Reddy, in his three-day official visit to Arunachal Pradesh and Nagaland, inaugurated several developmental works, reviewed schemes in Nagaland. He also laid foundation stone for the training cum examination center at Dimapur. Also, Shri Reddy inaugurated state soil testing laboratory in Kohima to help farmers achieve profitable crops. Samyukt Kisan Morcha, the farmers' body, has called for a Bharat Bandh on September 27, 2021. The strike has been called to intensify the farmers' movement against the three farm laws imposed by the Government of India. Considering the gravity of the situation, Assam University Silchar decided to reschedule the CBCS and LLB examinations, which was scheduled on September 27. The government and district administration of Hojai have decided to impose Section 144 in the district for the upcoming festivals Durga Puja and Diwali. The announcement has been made today for the safety of the people in Hojai. Education Minister Ranoj Pegu informed today that the Assam government has appointed Deepak Chakravarti as the chairman of the Assam Engineering Service Recruitment Board. Sri Chakravarti is a chemical engineer from Northwestern University, USA and gold medalist from Guwahati University. Sikkim Chief Minister Prem Singh Gole launched the scheme of One Family, One Entrepreneur in the state to support through various schemes aiming at the youth and rural populace in the state. Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee blasts center and claims it vengeful and jealous for denying her the permission to participate in the World Peace Conference in Rome. One of India's notable digital marketing firms, UEX Media and Technologies founder Yatendra Rajput, has recently announced the launch of additional digital marketing services to cater to each and every prerequisite of its clients. Prime Minister Narendra Modi landed in India today after concluding his three-day visit to the United States. During his visit, Prime Minister Modi addressed the 76th session of the United Nations Security Council, attended the first in-person Quad Summit and held bilateral and multilateral engagements. On his return, the BJP members at Delhi's Palam Technical Airport received the Prime Minister with a grand welcome. Punjab new Chief Minister Charanjit Singh Channi carried out his first cabinet expansion today. According to a report, the cabinet consists of a total of 18 MLA, including the Chief Minister himself. Union Minister Anurag Thakur today reviewed the construction work of the Zojila Pass Tunnel in the Kargil district of Ladakh. Anurag Thakur stated that the tunnel will play an important role in joining Srinagar, Kargil, Leh National Highway Authority of India. The Judima Rice Wine, a famous traditional wine of Assam's Dimasa tribe, has been awarded a geographical indication tag and becomes the first beverage to get this tag from the Northeast. The Indian Air Force today conducted an air show at Dal Lake in Srinagar to celebrate Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, commemorating 75 years of the country's independence. Lieutenant Governor Manoj Sinha flagged off the event organized by the Indian Air Force in collaboration with the Jammu and Kashmir government. In the country's first national cooperative conference, Union Minister Amit Shah appreciated the fertilizer cooperative IFCO's use of nanotechnology to make IFCO Nano Urea Liquid. Shah also described the role of IFCO in making the green revolution successful in the country and praised the world's first nano liquid urea manufactured by IFCO. Prime Minister Narendra Modi urged the startups to pay special attention to Ayurvedic and herbal products as India has witnessed an immense increase in their export over the years. Sports Minister Anurag Thakur today announced a month-long nationwide Clean India Drive from October 1 to get rid of single-use plastic and other waste. Anurag Thakur said that this will be the largest cleanliness drive in the world, in which more than 75 lakh tons of waste, primarily plastic waste, from different parts of the country will be collected and further processed in waste-to-wealth model. At least 4 Pakistan soldiers were killed and 2 others suffered injuries in a bomb blast on an army vehicle in the coast area of Harnai district in Balochistan. The United States handed over 157 artifacts and antiquities during Prime Minister Narendra Modi's visit. US President Joe Biden and Prime Minister Narendra Modi have committed to strengthen their efforts to combat theft, illicit trade and trafficking of cultural objects. And today's Assam COVID-19 update, total positive cases 196, recovery rate 98.27% and total death 5. That's the end of Top 20 News. Thank you for watching.